Hey everybody, it's Scorch2. Welcome back to another series. As promised, as would start quickly, Guacamelee 2. And if you're just joining this series, I recently just completed Guacamelee Super Turbo Champion Edition. The first entry, well, not really the first entry, but like a remake or a remaster of the first entry in a Guacamelee series where you play as Juan, a luchador. It's a side-scrolling kind of adventure beat-em-up. Pretty good. Pretty good controls, solid difficulty, really fun. Lots of stuff to go back and get, and this particular installment in the series adds a lot more challenges and, in my opinion, was a little more fun to make use of all the powers and special moves you get. So we're going to have a good time with this one. Let's jump right in. I'm going to have to clear out the save here, so let's clear out the first guy here. It's good. We're going to play on normal.
Previamente en Guacamelee.
He's going to give us a nice little recap of what happened. He's about to merge the worlds of the living and the dead. I'm back to reading the dialogue. This will be challenging for you, even in your prime. Don't worry, Juan, you got this. Thank you, Tostada. Ooh. Forget it. Let's go. So we're gonna recap the battle of Calaca. What is a luchador? A miserable little pile of secrets. Ha! I see what you did there. Ooh. It's not quite as hard this time around because we have a lot more health. And we don't have the shield to contend with. Bam. And he goes down a little quicker. It's just the prologue, of course. Just like the first battle with Dracula in Symphony of the Night, if you did not get that reference. Significantly easier, as it's the first fight in the game. She got skellied, if you remember the skeletonization. And then he turns into evil demon. Kanaka, god of living and the dead, trouble under my rule. Under my jewel. Remember exactly how to fight this guy. Only he doesn't kick your ass nearly as bad. They have more health and more health, and I'm stronger. He dies a lot quicker. If it was that easy at the end of the first game, I would have been a little disappointed. Hello. an epic tattoo. I think I might get one. Just like that. Not really. Who dares me? Campeón Juan. And he's let himself go a little bit. So there's that. Papa, are you looking at your posters again? It's playtime. Are you Googling your own name? Not at all. 7 years later. Up, up, up! I can't roll, I can't do nothing. Cielito, have you seen the kids? Yeah. I guess I'm gonna have to eat all the ice cream myself. That didn't appear to work. I think they're calling my bluff. Go check on them. I'm actually eat all the ice cream. Okay, first. What's up? I'm a tomato. I'm a mamato. He has a lot of liquor for drowning his sorrows. Who's hungry for tacos? I thought it was ice cream. Both are good, though. Not at the same time. That's gross. Well, they're almost ready. Esperanza, Juanito, get off the table. Oh no, we're all out of avocados. Your father must have eaten them all. Juan, maybe the market is still open. Do you think you could pick some up? I have to finish my dissertation. Alright, first portion of the game can be a little boring, especially if you're used to the series. That's all good. It will ramp up relatively quickly. Pueblucho. Got pretty good music. Hello. It's our hero, Juan. Come dine at my restaurant. I'll hook you up. One free appetizer. Crappetizer. Hello. Juan, so nice to see you out and about. I know Lupita worries sometimes. Enough to bring the family over again for dinner sometime soon. My new tortilla soup recipe will knock your calcetines off. Oh, I know you. The old hero emerges from his slumber. I haven't seen you run since the Great Tortilla Scare. How's the familia? Avocados. Hurry, I saw Frey Ayai run around the vendor. He looked hungry. Frey Ayai, is that his name? Seems just or like yesterday, we were rivals and Kalaka was defeated. How things have changed, mi amigo. Don't let him fool you. We still get to deal with him later. What's up, guy? Juan, looking for avocados? Frey bought them all today. Sorry. Maybe you could go see him in the church. Hello. Oh, Juan, you'd like some avocados? I had a full barrel earlier, but today I'm almost out. Tell you what, get rid of the empty barrel for me and I'll give you a few from my private stash. That sounds like a bribe. It's a very strong barrel or I'm very... going. I thought it'd be easier. Here you go. Oh no. Juan, can you go see what's happening? Those weird black things just appeared. Oh, those are fun. I know. No say. Juan, one of those black things is on the town statue, too. Esqueletos! Save us, Juan. Ooh, they just punched me. Uai Chivo.
Juan!
Sorry about the skeletons. I'm so glad I found you, man. Quickly, we must travel to the darkest timeline. The Mexiverse is in grave danger. Please, there's no time to explain. Jump through this portal. I'll meet you on the other side. Trust me, I have a bridge to sell you. Guess you should go. It sounds like they really need you. We'll be okay. Papa, you broke a skeleton. Give me back an alebrije, Dad. Juan, be careful. If you touch that stuff, you die, so don't do that. It'll be relevant later. As mentioned. From Limbo. That was a fun game. Oh no, this isn't right at all. This feels about halfway there, like some sort of purgatory. Definitely not the darkest timeline. Come on, it can't be much farther. Remember that scary shit? See that right there? That's not good. Bam! I want to play that game again. It's been a while since I played that. Pretty sure I played it on my channel. Bad hombres. Triple dragon. Rivera City Ransom. What's up, guy? El Presidente has been kidnapped by ninjas. Are you bad enough, hombre, to rescue El Presidente? This is the baddest timeline, not the darkest. Sorry, I'm a bit rusty with these portals. I'm feeling good about this next jump, though. Andale! Bad dudes. Darkest timeline. There it is. Found it. This is it. The darkest timeline. This way, please. Police. Oh my. I can barely believe it, senores. Uai Chivos, it was horrible. Please describe what happened. I was just fixing up my bike when Salvador, you know, the Salvador, the one that killed Calaca, showed up. He had a gang of weirdos with him, a magician, a dead dog lady, a talking cactus. His entourage. Careful, boss. The top one is not a step. The suspense is killing me again. What? No, I'm the brains. You're the muscle. Is that supposed to be like Krang?
Yar.
Shredder. I need to prepare my monologue. We dance. The golden relic. Soon I will reach the Molcajete. Its sacred contents will give me. I'm just some salsa stuck in my throat. I'm still as strong as ever. What does that look like to you? The golden relic. This could mean trouble. Also, after Salvador took the relic, strange black things began to appear in the sky. And the skeletons are becoming more frequent. No bones about it. Nyah, nyah, nyah. Oh, you're back, Chivo 24. Didn't see you there. We were just doing things. Discussing current events. Wait. Please don't tell me that is the Juan. Yes, the last Juan left alive, the very Juan I told you about. He defeated Kalaka in his timeline, saved Lupita, and survived. Incredible. This is the Juan? Tis. Alright, well, only surviving Juan, please step forward. The real Slim Shady, please stand up. I have not heard. Salvador has taken one of the three relics created by the God of Time. A virus. The end of the Mexiverse. That would be very unsavory. Go find the Mask Guardian Tostada in the mangrove swamp to the east, Los Manglares. Tostada will help you find the sacred mask. You're going to need it if you hope to stop Salvador. Okay. Here's our map. It's very similar to most maps everywhere. Ooh. Tortilla. Used to be a tequila maker who lived here not long ago. You look a lot like him. You could be his cousin. Hello, Hat Man. Be careful. Nobody's lived out here for years. Nothing left but dust and the odd esqueleto. Okay, now we make our way. Oh, look at that. Also look at that. This is dark indeed. Oh, hello. If you fall in, just reset. Some of these hazards are not instant death. Screw attack nonsense. Let's go. People to meet. Hello. I believe you are who I'm looking for. Juan? It is you. Why, Chivo really did it, that crazy goat. It's me, Tostada, guardian of the mask. Really strange to see you again. Nice mustache, by the way. So thick. You're so close to defeating Kalaka this timeline, Juan. I swear, we won't make the same mistake with Salvador. It's true, we won't. Spoiler. Just hold still and close your eyes. We'll only take a second. Judo chop. Knock me out. How rude. Okay, well, can't go that way. So, must go this way. You can't go right, you must go left. And then... just never mind the floating face in the sky. So sorry about killing you back there. I had to get you to the world of the dead. Anyway, look, here it is. It's a bit tattered from the last adventure. But it's waiting for you, Juan. Go on, before you turn into a skeleto. Put it on your face. instant muscle. I believe I have something to show you. It is over there. That's the Juan I remember, although I kind of miss seeing the mustache. Trust me, it's still there. Now I just need to get you back to the world of the living. Think about that part. Council could help with that. Further east in Pentanillo, the swamp town. Let's go. I'll be around if you need me. So she's the additional player. If you want to play two player, you can do that. There's multiple players, as you can kind of see up there. When the screen transitions as such. I have not had the pleasure of experiencing the four-player mode, but I'm sure it is a riot. I do believe we're going this way, so we are on the right way. So we get some of our skills now that we have our mask, which will be helpful. We get these little challenge rooms every so often. They'll be very abundant throughout the majority of the game. Some of them get pretty fucking hard. There's no fucking around with this game. It's arguably more difficult. But that's good though. It's not like unfairly difficult. And a lot of the stuff that's really hard, you actually don't even need to do. But some stuff that really is hard, you do have to do, so you can't really pick and choose too much. These guys are relatively irritating. They are too. You have to roll through them. You gotta turn around quickly or they'll own you. Again, luckily it's not an instant death room, so you don't need to worry about falling in there. It's just a little annoying, that's all. No big deal. So, sir, you always get a reward. Rewards are nice. And a checkpoint. Heavy jump, light jump, heavy jump, light jump. And treasure box. That have money or health pieces or special move power-ups, the usual stuff that shouldn't be too much of a surprise. Excellent. These fucking guys again. And the hit detection is a little iffy with some of them too, so it's pretty easy to get hit even though you're not like arguably within range. That's fine though. I'll start complaining about how cheap it is later. Dude's throwing the bones will get pretty annoying too. Throw through the walls, which is like extra like shitty. Speaking of health power up. The nifty little rooster crowing. Kick to the ceiling, that's all. We'll be able to power up our moves later. Down here. Let's see, skills. We haven't met the folks that will end up giving us our skills. But once we do, you purchase them through that menu instead of going to the checkpoint like in the last game. Oh, a Chozo statue. Juan, tostada. Finally, Dios mio, my butt is getting numb from hiding in that position. You really like looking like a proper luchador now, Juan. But flashy garb means nothing without the fundamentals. You need to get reacquainted with that proper, with the proper moves if you're going to face Salvador. As you forgot, Chozo statues hold the secrets of the ancient luchador techniques. The one you just rudely destroyed contained the legendary rooster uppercut. The rupper cut breaks red blocks and can be performed in the air. If you do too much, you'll tire yourself out for a while. That's what you get for getting fat, letting yourself go. Alright. Up we go. You have to use it to gain some ground. You have to let it recharge. Come on. Toasty. I don't think so. Knockback can get pretty annoying too. That's not new to this game. Knockback is annoying in lots of games. You can almost sometimes tell when you're gonna get met with one of these stupid, like, little, mini boss fights or mini boss fights. That counts as a stun. Not technically stunned. Okay, let's go in here and kill this dude first. That doesn't count. Delayed response there. Okay. I'm gonna get knocked down because hit that thing anyway. Shit. Not see him there. Up we go. Alright. Making quick progress. Did not work. Here. Must not have had enough juice. Let's just wait till we get the double jump. Wait, spoilers. Okay.